I'm Dr. Philip Wong, and I work at the National Institutes of Health in the Office of Intramural Training and Education. I am the director of the Graduate Partnerships Program, or GPP for short. The GPP is a collaborative education program where PhD-level students from universities all over the world can come to the NIH Intramural Research Program to perform all or part of their doctoral dissertation research. Currently, we have about 400 graduate students, and overall they have represented over 100 different universities worldwide. GPP students are full-time students at the home university and full-time trainees at the NIH. The students receive their degree from the home university but perform research at the NIH. There are two main pathways to enter the GPP: institutional partnerships and individual partnerships. For the most part, institutional partnerships are for prospective PhD students that are interested in applying to and entering graduate school, whereas for individual partnerships, those are students that are currently enrolled in a PhD program. For institutional partnerships, the NIH has established formal agreements with a number of domestic and international universities, and these students are typically with us from the start to the finish of their graduate program. Today, I'm going to focus on the second pathway for the GPP listed here, called individual partnerships. This is where a currently enrolled PhD student can come to the NIH for all or part of the doctoral dissertation research. I also want to emphasize that no matter which pathway you come through, all graduate students at the NIH are welcome to participate in OITE and GPP training activities. Through the individual partnership, a student that is currently enrolled in a PhD program can, at some point in their graduate program, seek to collaborate with an NIH intramural investigator and join the GPP. The individual partnership is designed for students that have completed their coursework and other candidacy-related academic milestones and are ready to focus on their dissertation research. For students in U.S. programs, that's typically after the first or second year is complete, but timelines can differ depending on your program. In terms of eligibility, GPP individual partnerships are open to currently enrolled PhD students that are U.S. citizens, permanent residents, or foreign nationals. The partner university can be anywhere in the world, and the NIH mentor must be a principal investigator in the NIH Intramural Research Program. Also, there is no application season or application fee for individual partnerships. They can be formed year-round. So here are the steps to create an individual partnership. The first item is to discuss the possibility of performing your research at the NIH with your university mentor and department. You might introduce them to the GPP by sharing our website or this video, and the GPP staff and I are always happy to answer questions. Importantly, you must have permission from your department to be a GPP student. The next step is to identify an NIH investigator that is willing to mentor you for your dissertation research. I encourage you to check out our website on finding a mentor and familiarizing yourself with the NIH Annual Reports database and the various NIH intramural websites. Also, seek guidance from your university mentor and use your university networks. Then, take the initiative to reach out to an NIH investigator. Craft a professional and concise email explaining why you wish to work with this particular person and start a conversation. After you've emailed an NIH principal investigator, don't be discouraged if you don't hear back immediately, and also don't be discouraged if they respond saying that they don't have the resources for a graduate student at that particular time. Finding the right mentor is one of the most vital parts of your graduate experience, and sometimes it can take a considerable amount of effort. Here at the NIH, we have over 1,200 principal investigators, and many of them are passionate about graduate education. Also, I wanted to note that if you email someone and you don't hear back after several days, feel free to send them a friendly follow-up. One of the beauties of the individual partnership is that there is a degree of flexibility in crafting your partnership. In your discussions with your university mentor and your prospective NIH mentor, make sure everyone has a clear understanding of the financial and administrative aspects of the agreement, as well as the length of time that you'll be performing your research at the NIH. The typical financial items to discuss include who's going to fund the stipend, health insurance, and tuition. Some students come with outside funding from their home university or other organization, whereas some students seek to be funded entirely by the NIH investigator, or there's a combination thereof in the event that the funding sources are compatible. If you are seeking to combine NIH intramural funding with another funding source and you have questions, please let me know and I'd be happy to discuss. It can be complicated at times because certain types of funds cannot mix, but depending on the circumstances, oftentimes there is a solution. It's important to note that all NIH PhD students here for 6 months or greater must receive a stipend in accordance with the NIH predoctoral IRTA and visiting fellow scale. The stipend must come from an institutional source, meaning personal or family funds cannot count towards a stipend. For more information on this policy, see the link on this slide. So once your discussions are complete, please register for a GPP Individual Partnership through our online application center. The system will ask you for some personal information and the name of your NIH mentor. Once you register, the NIH mentor will be sent an official copy of the Memorandum of Understanding template and will be asked to confirm that a training offer has been extended. The Memorandum of Understanding, or MOU, formalizes the partnership and must be completed for each student performing research within the NIH for 6 months or greater. The MOU basically spells out the responsibilities of the university, the NIH, the mentor, and the student. Again, upon submission of the GPP application, a copy of the MOU template will be sent to the NIH investigator and will confirm that an offer to train has been extended. The MOU must be completed and filed in the GPP office prior to your arrival. The NIH mentor, in collaboration with the university mentor and department officials, should prepare the MOU template according to the agreements set forth by all parties. Please note that any modifications to the language of the MOU really needs to be discussed with the GPP office and may require extensive review. So in general, completing the MOU template includes filling in the appropriate spaces with names of individuals and institutions. But the one exception is the financial appendix for the MOU. That page is meant to be edited to reflect the agreements that have been made, namely who's funding the stipend, health insurance, and tuition. The MOU must be signed by the student, the NIH mentor, the NIH Institute or Center Scientific Director, the University Advisor, and the leadership of the student's university. Finally, it must be signed by the OITE Director. Additional signatures may also be required depending on the situation. For example, many NIH institutes and centers require the signature of the NIH Training Director. Once the MOU process is complete, the sponsoring NIH Institute or Center Administrative Office may proceed with the appropriate paperwork to appoint the student within the NIH. So these are the types of appointments. First, Predoctoral Intramural Research Training Award Fellow. So this is for U.S. citizens and permanent residents that receive full NIH intramural funding for stipend and health insurance. Next, Predoctoral Visiting Fellow. This is for foreign nationals that are receiving full NIH intramural funding. Next is a supplemental pre-doc IRTA or visiting fellow. So this is if the NIH is contributing to part of the funding. Next is a special volunteer. This is if you're fully funded by another source and the stipend parity rules are completely satisfied. And finally, a guest researcher appointment is not common for GPP students, but under certain circumstances where a special volunteer appointment might not apply, a guest researcher might be appropriate with the approval of the Office of Intramural Research. For international students, please note that the sponsoring NIH institute or center must submit the appropriate appointment paperwork to the NIH Division of International Services, or DIS. The MOU must be complete in order for DIS to process the package. So to the NIH mentors and administrative staff watching, please make sure you send the MOU to us before you submit the package to DIS. Otherwise, you may end up with some unintended delays. For international students who are on an F1 visa, approval of the MOU from the University International Office is also required. So why come to the NIH for your graduate education? Well, I could spend a whole video just on this topic, but for now, I'll sum it up with this slide and really emphasize the ability to do cutting-edge science, being a part of a vibrant community of fellow graduate students, having great collaborative opportunities, and having the full resources of the NIH Office of Intramural Training and Education, as well as the training directors and training offices within the NIH institutes and centers to really focus on your career and professional development. So if you're looking for an exciting collaborative program that really bridges your home university and the NIH, I encourage you to check it out. And once you're here, make sure you attend our OITE orientation for new graduate students to learn all about our community and how to make the most of your experience here at the NIH. So in summary, if you're a currently enrolled PhD student anywhere in the world and you're interested in performing all or part of your doctoral dissertation research at the National Institutes of Health, I recommend checking out the GPP Individual Partnerships. So actually about 50% of our GPP students come through individual partnerships. So it is a great mechanism that has the flexibility to adapt to a wide variety of scenarios. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like more information, please feel free to email me at wangph@mail.nih.gov and visit our website at training.nih.gov.